Kind of when you were born, mom gave me a little toy car, and mom, you know, my mom told me that this car was from her, and I believed her. And growing up, when I first got my driver's license, I remember picking up Kana from the library. And on the way out, I remember damaging the passenger side window, or the mirror. And thanks for not telling mom and dad. You know, today's their first time hearing this. And a few years down the road, I remember I had to pick up Kana from work. And, you know, I completely forgot about it because I was watching a movie with my friends. And dad got so mad at me. But, you know, thank you for lying to dad afterwards and telling him that, you know, you had to work overtime anyway so that he wouldn't get mad, so thank you. And more recently, you know, when my wife and I, we got married, you know, Kana did all of our artwork. You know, without you, we wouldn't have had such a beautiful wedding, so thank you. And, you know, these are just, you know, examples of times when Kana has been, you know, a great sister, but you know, you're the world's greatest sister. You know, you always supported me with whatever I did or whatever mom and dad did. So, you know, I am who I am today because of you. And I'm so happy that I was born into the same family as you. You know, you might have a new last name now and you might be part of a new family, but you are and always will be my one and only little sister. So I love you both. And congratulations.
I went to high school with John, grew up together. I had the pleasure of knowing him since like seventh grade or something. It's been a while. And unfortunately, I haven't got enough time to spend with Kana, but I've been able to see snapshots every once in a while when they come home. They've always looked so happy together. John and I played soccer together growing up, and we've been on the same team for like 5 years. And we grew a lot along the way. We played right next to each other, both center backs, and he was kind of the rock that kept the defense together. And Kana, you're so lucky you have that in your relationship.
Four years ago, on the very first day I met you, I thought you were just a nice and smiley, athletic guy who looked less Asian but spoke better Japanese than me. Ever since day one, you have been surprising me with how great of a guy you are. As our story developed after bumping into each other numerous times in the first few days of freshman orientation, we knew. We knew we had something special even after I said no to being your girlfriend twice. And we had no idea how much our lives were about to change. Sometimes I worry that you're too nice because you don't give yourself enough credit and you always put others first. But I realize that that is exactly why I love you. You're kind, patient, caring, and are always willing to help without question. I'm so lucky to be in love and to have someone like you to spend the rest of my life with.
I have my notes here. My first line says, I'm not going to cry. About a year and a half ago, we did a Skype with Kana and Jonathan. And in preparation for the Skype, Jonathan and Kana had prepared a YouTube video for us to watch during the Skype. Their idea was, they wanted to see what our reactions were when he asked for permission to marry Kana. Right. So it was really easy. I naturally said, yes, no problem. Right. Because we like John very much. It suddenly clicked. Kana's getting married. Yeah. Oh my God, Kana's leaving us. That's when the crying started. I cried, Kana cried, but John and Mitchell, they were laughing.
Thank you for saying yes after all the no's. Thank you for making me smile. And thank you for always being there for me. On this day, I share my promises to you. I promise to love you to the moon and back, through thick and thin, and through the joys and the struggles. I promise to never settle, to never stop, and to keep moving forward with you. But most importantly, I promise that I'll never be someone who I'm not. I promise that wherever we go, whatever we do, I won't lose sight of what brought us together.
I'm a little bit upset with John for giving me the toasting duties. But considering that I only need to convince everyone here how great him and Kana are, I would say that my job is actually pretty hard to mess up. My job's also a lot easier because, unlike most wedding speeches, I don't have to try and prove that their married life is going to be a success. That was so last year. As a result, today I'll be more like a sports analyst commenting on a veteran's rookie season, as if actually contributing some sort of insight into the situation. Conathon has already made a splash in their first season in the majors, and I have to say that the pre-wedding and post-wedding Conathon is much the same beast. I can say this because, given my status as the cranky slob of a roommate, I've not only had behind-the-scenes access into their lives, but I've also pushed their buttons once or twice to see what happens. And I can assure you, nothing happens.
And I am reminded of how truly lucky I am to have such a strong and hardworking friend. And with this beautiful friendship, I have also had the pleasure to gain another friend, John. I have learned many things from them, but most of all, I believe they taught me and shown me what true love looks like.
So with the blessing of all your family and friends, I now pronounce you husband and wife.
Both of you are very talented. You know, you have a lot of skills, you know, in a number of areas. And, you know, I think that, you know, and we heard it this morning, you know, follow your passion, follow your dreams, you know, help each other to do that. And I'm sure, you know, you will have a very, you know, a great success, you know, together. Congratulations to both of you. You know, we're really happy. And this one.
To Jonathan and Kana. Thank you.
Cause every time before it feels like maybe, yes, and maybe love you.